Are you happy if someone looked you in the eye right now and asked you, are you happy? What would you say?
Live happy, fun, loving, and carefree.
Are you happy right now? I've been thinking about this a lot lately because, you know, we've been talking, there's so much in the news, and me sharing with you my thoughts on things is I don't want to come across as a not happy person. I mean, that's live happy, fun, loving, and carefree. I say that for a reason. That's always what we want to think about, is to be happy living right now. So when you think about the things that have happened in your past, and you're thinking about the things that, you know, might happen down the road in the future, and you're preparing, is it's really, really important to live today, right now, you know, living in the present. Who's driving the bus in your life? And I'm kind of worried that I've given the wrong impression in some of my recent videos. Like the past video that I just did was talking about inflation and what, you know, we all should be doing to prepare for inflation. But I'm not talking about gloom and doom. I'm not talking about, you know, prepping where you think the end of the world is coming and things like that. And you spend all of your time being concerned and even afraid of what might happen down the road, that you forget to live today. You get up out of bed today, and it's important to live life. So when somebody asks you the question, are you happy? You know, what does that mean to you? And you want to, they're happy. You want to live, you know, in the day. And I just think about, like, back when we were living on our sailboat full time, when we lived on our sailboat for 9 years full time, and Thursdays were our date day. And the two of us, we would go to town or run errands or go to the park or for a walk. We would just go do fun things, and we wouldn't be concerned about, you know, if the boat needed a repair, or we had a bill to pay, or whatever, you know, might be going wrong. We just had a fun day. We might go out to lunch to eat. Back then, you could go out as a couple at lunchtime, even on the coast, you know, living on the boat for $20. And so we would just be goofy. We would be, for lack of a better term, we would be very childlike. And I'm surprised we never got arrested doing the crazy things that we were doing, or at least kicked out of the places that we were, because we're pretty, you know, dancing in the grocery store. We might go to a store like Hobby Lobby and just goof around with the stuff that was in there. You know, we would just be, quote, childlike and have fun. And that's the kind of things, you know, to live in the moment. Now we're, you know, with us, we're here on our homestead now, and Mondays are kind of our date day, if you will. We're sort of now at the point where we like staying home, and sometimes we don't do anything but just hang out and, you know, just spend the day together, not doing anything in particular. But we do run, you know, we go to town every few weeks, and we might go out to lunch, even though it's a lot more expensive now because of inflation. But we still try to just have a fun, good day and just be not serious about things. Because the point there is, what I want you to sort of think about is that saying, and I don't believe in mistakes. I don't think that anything, much of anything, is an actual mistake. Is that we make choices on things, and then a certain outcome happens, and it might not be the outcome that you were hoping for. But I really don't like to say, well, that was a mistake. It was just things didn't quite work out the way that we want. And just like a boat changing directions, when the wind changes, you know, you change to move with it. So, you know, there's a saying that don't continue making a mistake just because you've invested so much time in making it. So, you know, eliminate that word mistake. But a lot of times we're in a position where we are, we're living in the place that we're living, or we're driving the car that we're driving, or we're in the job that we have, and we've got so much invested into it that even though we know we should be thinking about doing something different, we don't want to change because we're so invested in that mistake, in that choice that we've made. And that's the thing that I want you to get rid of, and that thought. And so, like, you know, if we think that inflation is coming, you know, we invest in buying durable goods or you know, whatever type of thing that is appropriate for you. If we think that the end of the world's coming and we've got to, you know, prep for things down the road, is, you know, that's one of the reasons we're on the homestead, is our garden's right over there, just off the camera is our garden. And we've got wild service berries that are still ripe that I'm picking and eating. And we've got a whole big plot of, on the other side of the barn there, we've got a big plot of blackberries, and they're not quite ripe yet. They're probably another week or two and they'll be getting ripe, and we'll pick those. And, you know, just enjoying what you have now, even though you're, you know, remembering the past, you're remembering the things that made you what you are, because, you know, that's the person I am today, right now standing here, the person that you are is because of all the things that happened to you from the moment you were born till this moment right now. And to think that something was a mistake, to think that, well, if I could go back and change that and do that different, well, then we wouldn't be right here right now. Because if you're driving down the road and you turned right 10 miles back, well, you're on a completely different path now. And so, you know, that's why I don't believe in mistakes. It's just, as we make choices, we ebb and flow, and we get to where we are. So all life's chapters, everything that we've done, has made us the person that we are. All the good things that have happened and all the bad things that have happened is where we are now. And sure, think about the future. Think about, well, if inflation comes, am I prepared for that? If you know, I'm a non-essential worker and they decide to shut down the business that I work at. That happened to me a long, long time ago, back in, roughly 1983 or so. I had a corporate job working for a big, big company, and about a Fortune 200 or so. I don't think they were Fortune 100 yet, but they were a big, big company outside of Chicago. And one day the big boss called us in and said, we've sold this division to a company out in California, and in 6 months you don't have a job anymore. You know, it's kind of like, well, gee, thanks. You know, and I made the decision based upon that situation. I made a change in direction in my life, saying that's never going to happen again. And I've been self-employed, you know, since then. I thought, I'm never going to have a job that, even though I'm doing a good job, the boss can come in and tell me I don't have a job anymore. So, you know, because of that happening to me, I decided that I was going to be self-employed and operate my own businesses so that I could fire myself if I wanted to. And that's gotten me to where I am. So just think about those things. Think about where you are now. What could you do? You know, think about the future. Again, like I just said, you know, the inflation thing. Are things going to get really, really bad? Is the job market going to go bad? Is housing going to get, you know, ridiculously expensive? Are 2x4s going to be hard to come by? You know, just think of all the things of where you are now and the things that you want to do and make good choices. But please remember that, are you happy? Make sure what you're doing right now today is making you happy. Laugh and have fun. I've had people say, oh, your laugh is so fake. Believe me, ask the people in the hardware store, in the grocery store, if I'm this really like this, you know, when I engage with other people. That's just who I am. This isn't, I'm not faking it for the camera. And, you know, just have fun. Dance in the grocery store. Be, you know, be goofy in Hobby Lobby. and, you know, run around with the chainsaw and Home Depot and until they threaten to kick you out. Just have some fun and live in the moment. Be the person driving your bus. And again, remember the past, because that's why you're where you are today. You know, the job things that happened to me and life's events that have happened to me is why we're here on this homestead today. That's why you're where you are. And think and prepare for the future, but don't let it consume you. Don't be so consumed that things are going to be so bad in the future and you've got to be prepped for it that you're just not living today. One of my favorite sayings, I actually have it on the cover of the book that I wrote 10 or 11 years ago, is deferring life until later is like saving sex for old age. You don't want to do that. You want to live today. You want to be in the moment. So think about those things. Be happy. Are you happy? It's all about living happy, fun, loving, and carefree. So hey, watch this video because I know you'll find it really interesting too. And if for some reason you're not subscribed, think about subscribing so you'll be notified when the next video comes out. Because I truly want you living happy. Living happy, fun, loving, and carefree. And when somebody asks you, are you happy? You can honestly say, you bet I am.